All right, so I'm outside of a 2020 Honda Pilot. This is the EX model. It's lunar silver with a gray interior. So I just wanna walk you around this car and show you a couple of different features off of it and kind of let you know a little bit about the vehicle. This is one model above the base, and then above this, there are gonna be several models. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start you at the back of the car. The first thing I wanna show you is the key on the car. So it does have a key fob, and it has the ability to start the car with a remote start. To do so, press my lock button and then press and hold my remote start button and the car will fire up for me. You'll usually see the little flash and then it'll crank on. So that's how that works. Now, if I crank it up and I want to run it for 10 minutes, that's all I got to do. If I want to extend that, press that same sequence again and it'll run for another 10. So now I got 20 minutes. Now, if I crank it up and realize I just want to turn the car back off, I'm not going to leave, press the unlock button and the remote start button and it'll turn it off. Now, this next button is a little bit confusing on the EX model. It just unlocks the tailgate. To get a power tailgate, you would need to go up one model to the EXL. So let's pop this open and show you a couple different things. I've got the third row folded down right now, so that way you can kind of get an idea for space. If you were comparing this to a Passport, that would be an idea for what you're working with. If you want the third row, the Pilot's a great option, you can flip them up. But I want to show you the storage first. This is a little bit different from the Passport in the sense that I have either hidden storage right there, or I can drop this down in, and now I've got some storage to keep stuff from sliding around. This is really nice because you can fit carry-on bags there stacked up next to each other. Or if I got groceries with fruit and vegetables and milk and stuff that I don't want sliding all around, I can keep it that way. Now, right now, I have taken this off, but there's a cap cover right here, and it has a symbol of a gas symbol. So if you couldn't get your gas to pop open, for some reason it got stuck, you can pop that open and pull this trigger right here, and it'll actually pop the gas cap. So you can see now it's open to where I can access it. So I just wanted to point that out. Not a lot of people know where that is. You do have air vents in the back. They're right here. And then you have another air vent right here. So just so you can see, the third row does have air vents. They do have cup holders. So I'm gonna pull up my third row so you can see how this works and give you an idea for the storage space too. So that way you have an idea for what's going on. So that way you can see I do have some storage space. And I've actually got this set up a little bit to where you have an edge to where you can have a little bit of a recline or not to this. So just depending on how you want to do it. So just something to be aware of. Or I can also leave these down. So if I want the third row up, but I don't want these so I can give it a little more visibility out of the back, you can do that too. So just some different things you can do. So third row, that way you can get an idea for that. Let's move around to that second row and I'll shoot you into that third row so you can see a little bit more about it. So point this out while I got it open. It is capless. So you saw back there that I had a funnel. In case you ran out of gas, you would need that funnel to keep this open while you pour gas into it. Other than that, this is just nice because you don't have to make sure you screw on that cap. And accidentally, if you don't, you set off the check engine light and then you have to go through that whole thing. You don't have to worry about that anymore. This eliminates that. So we're gonna move into the second row of this vehicle and show you a couple things there. All right, so second row. This is a cloth interior, so that's what I mentioned earlier. The LX and EX are cloth interiors. Your EXL and above are gonna be leather interiors. So I do have a one push button right here that I can press. That'll actually fold my seats forward. So I did that with one finger, and now these have slid forward and opened for me. So you can get into that third row. I will say this third row, I'm 6 foot. I can sit back there actually comfortably. And the cool thing about this third row is if I have somebody taller, these are adjustable. I have a bar so I can slide these up and down all over the place and make room depending on what I need. So you can see how I have it slid forward compared to the other one. So it's just some different things you can do if you got a little one up front, but a big person behind them or however you need to juggle people. So I will point out you do have air controls back here. So my fan speed, turning it on and off, my hot and cold. It is a digital display, so you can see it right there. Well, you can kind of see right now. I got a little bit of a glare going here. But that's what's going on from that standpoint of the vehicle. My second row, just so you're aware of what's going on with it. So let's move up to the front row of the car. So the first thing I want to point out is the car does have keyless entry. So what that means is I can walk up, put my hand on the door handle, it'll automatically unlock. When I'm getting out, I can press this. The door is now locked. You heard it beep. When I walk up, if I put my hand in, you heard it beep. Now it's unlocked. So I don't have to get the keys out of my pocket and then I can get in the car and just crank it up. It's really nice when you have your hands full, whether it's kiddos, bags, whatever it may be. I will point out right here that you do have a powered seat on this side. That side is not powered in this vehicle. You would need to go up one model to the EXL to get powered on both sides. But it is 10-way, so you got front, back, up, down, your back controls, and then you do have a, as far as your lower lumbar support, you can control that there too. So sit down in here and point out a couple things. So I remote started it, something I should point out. You'll notice the car's on the AC's running, but nothing electronic is running right now. To do so, press in my foot on the brake, tap that start button. Now it's gonna crank up the remaining parts of the vehicle. So that's what's going on. That's how you use the remote start. So don't be worried if you use the remote start and you're going, hey, I don't think this is working or whatever the case may be. So starting you over here on the left side of the dash, I'm going to point out a couple things. The first is the window controls. You do have auto up, down on your passenger and driver side. Your window locks, or excuse me, your window locks right here, and then your door locks are right there. Down below down there, you can see my gas cap, if I need to pop it, is right there. And then my trunk, or excuse me, my hood release is right down there on the side. So you can get to it if I open that up, you can see a little bit better. So there's three buttons right here that I want to talk about. The first one right here with the LED on is your, lane departure mitigation system. So if it's on, what it means is if I start to drive off the shoulder of the road, it's going to be an audible alert and it's set up to shake the wheel to wake you up. It's assuming you're getting drowsy. Maybe you're starting to drive off the road on a long trip. And I can turn this feature on and off. All I got to do is press it. LED's on, it's on. If it's off, it's off. Above that is my collision mitigation braking system. What that is if it's looking like I'm gonna rear end a car in front of me, first it's gonna give me an audible alert, and then if I don't apply the brakes, it's gonna start to apply the brakes to prevent the accident. So that's what the function of this is. It's always on and running. I have to press it for a couple seconds to turn it off. And you can tell when it's off because you'll see that indicator right there. And when I press it to turn it back on, the indicator will go off and it'll also alert me up here in the dash. So it lets you know. The one next to that is vehicle stability assist. This works with your traction control. So in the event that you go into a skid, it's gonna help transfer power to whichever wheel has better traction to help correct that skid. Really no point in turning this off unless you're stuck in the mud and you wanted to be spinning your tires while somebody's trying to pull you out. Other than that, there's not really a reason that I can come up with. But that's what this button does. Always on and running, just like this one. Above that, your econ button. If I turn this button on, you'll see a green leaf pop up right there, and it'll let me know right there. It will improve gas mileage in the car, but in doing so, you're gonna give up a couple things. You're gonna give up some acceleration off the gas pedal, and you're gonna give up a little bit of the AC power, so it's gonna affect the fan a little bit. For most people, you'll never notice it. You could probably roll around all the better and get better gas mileage. For a little bit more heavy-footed, pedal-to-the-metal kind of people, maybe you turn it on and off as you go. There's no requirements. You don't have to be a stop or anything. You can turn it on and off whenever. The question I always get is, how much better can my gas mileage be, Justin? Well, the answer to that is it's kind of relative to the driver. Could you get 2, 3, 4, 5 miles extra per gallon? Absolutely you can, but it depends on your driving habits. If you're super heavy-footed and your gas and brake real hard, don't know that you're gonna see the results out of this that conservative driver would see. So just be aware of that. Now, your mirror controls, left and right side, and then I adjust off the pad right here. So pretty easy to understand. A lot of cars have this setup. I don't think I need to touch too much on that. When we're moving up to mirrors, I will point out you do have blind spot monitoring in this vehicle. So in your EX, you now gain that feature right there. And then you can see I have some tweeters over there. Just since I'm here, I'll point them out. Now, as far as my display up here, so you can see I have a basic menu screen up here, and I can toggle through what's on that screen with this button right here. So you can see me scrolling down, try to get both of them in the screen there at once. So I'm gonna start you off at the very top, and we'll just kind of walk through some different things. The first one's kind of cool because it just lets you know that you can hide different apps. So if you're like, man, I never need to look at my all-wheel drive torque management system, I can hide that app if you want. But let's go down to the next one. So my trip computer, exactly what it sounds like. It's gonna show me current and previous trips, how many miles I have on this tank of gas, which is right there, 384. And then and just general in the screen, I can see I have 7 miles on this car and it's 96 degrees outside here in Austin. So I'm gonna jump back out of that screen using the back button right here and scroll down one, all-wheel drive torque management. This is just letting you know if you're driving two-wheel drive or all-wheel drive. The great thing I like about all-wheel drive vehicles, and that's coming from someone who owns a four-wheel drive vehicles, it automatically switches over for you. So for the person who wants that extra traction, if they drive in snow occasionally or a lot, it's nice to know that it'll automatically flip over and do what it needs to keep you safe versus having to stop, shift it into four-wheel drive low, high, and have to play that game and know better and know how to use it. So just a little bit more intuitive as far as the vehicle goes. Now moving down one screen, my Bluetooth options, I don't have a phone connected up right now, but if I did, this is where I would get into some of those options as far as making calls. Now playing, if I've got something pulled up, so let me pull up FM here and you'll see kind of what it looks like. I've got KVET here, which is a local country station. It pulls up and shows me what I'm listening to. So easy enough on how that works. I think you can grasp that. So I'm gonna jump back out of that. Scroll down one more, maintenance. So this is actually kind of cool. It'll show me my tire pressure per tire. So if one of them is a little bit lower than the others, which you can see actually one is right now, I can check and see exactly which one. I'm gonna back out of that screen and go down. My oil life is right here. When it gets down to 15%, it's gonna give you an alert here. So it'll show you one right here and you'll get a little indicator. And it's gonna let you know exactly what they're gonna recommend. It'll say A1 or A2 or B1 or B2. you can either Google it, you can look in your manual. Honda's been doing this forever, but it'll let you know. So that way, when you go into the dealership or wherever you're going to go, it'll, you know, you can look up that code and it'll tell you, oh, you're due for oil filter and tire rotation, or just oil change or whatever it may be. So that way, if you're worried about getting upsold and going to the dealership or feeling like you might get taken advantage of or whatever the case may be, know that you can check that. It's available to you. So moving on to the steering wheel. My volume controls are right here, so plus and minus. I think that's pretty self-explanatory. You saw me moving around on the menu screen, which I'll do so again. When I press up and down, it toggles for me, and then to select something I can press enter. Left and right, so right now it's letting me jump around over to some different stuff. So if I keep pressing over, it's gonna jump between my favorite stations, which is just kind of nice because I don't have to touch it. And you can see it doing it over here, so it'll show you whenever I'm pressing left and right. So just kind of a cool thing that it does. It's a quick entry thing. My home button jumps back to the main screen that you see up here in case I get caught up in a menu and I don't know where I'm at. And you can always back out of menu screens there too. My Bluetooth control, so to answer a call, to hang up a call, and to use voice command. So I can press this. It'll start me through the prompts. And then you can see my prompts on the screen, FM, and I can keep going from there, which I'm not gonna do. I'm gonna back out of that. This also works with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. So if I'm using those, I can use it for my navigation directions, I can use it for Spotify, I can use it for a whole lot of different apps. So just keep in mind, this is a dual purpose button right here. Over on the right side of the steering wheel is gonna be some of my Honda sensing features. So the first button I wanna show you is the main button. When I press this button, you're gonna see ACC and LKS pop up there. That stands for Adaptive Cruise Control and Lane Keep Assist. Adaptive Cruise Control is set up to where when I'm going down the highway, press my speed and set it. From there, I can set the distance it keeps between me and the car in front of me using that button. The more boxes, the more space it keeps between me and that car, and that's using this button right here. So if I want a bunch of space, because that's how I feel comfortable, then I do that. If people keep cutting in front of me, I cut down on that space. If a car gets in front of me, it's still gonna create the amount of space I've selected at the speed I've determined, unless it needs to slow the car down to keep that distance. So if a car in front of me keeps dropping down to 55, my car will keep that amount of spacing and slow down to 55, and then when I get out from behind him, it'll take me back up to whatever speed I set it to. Now, if you're saying to yourself, hey, that's great and all, but I just want normal cruise control, no big deal. Press and hold that button. You hear it beep. Now it says cruise mode right there. Now I'm on classic cruise control. To switch back, press the button. There you go. If I'm using classic cruise, set, cancel, and the plus and the minus will adjust my speeds. It will adjust the speeds on the adaptive cruise control too, so easy enough. Now over here on the left side, I will point out your lighting controls, so auto. Easy enough, it'll turn on and off for me and my fog light controls. They're on if the hashtag's right there, or excuse me, hash mark. Over here, pull down to set my windshield wipers off, and then my back controls are right there. Moving over to my touchscreen. So I'm gonna show you a couple things here. The first one I'll point out is that you've got all these different buttons and options here, so a lot to work with here. But what I will say is, let's say you wanna customize it because you're like, man, I really only use like 3 or 4 buttons. Just press and hold on a button. When that pops up, you can now move stuff around. So you're like, I really just need my Bluetooth, be able to call people, F them because I like my station, and then Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Cool, that's how I want it. Press done, it'll save those right there. And you saw I had a couple screens worth of stuff here. So I'm gonna touch on this stuff and explain what some of it is. Bluetooth, first thing I wanna do is show you how to connect a phone. If you've never connected up a phone, hit connect phone, connect new device. It'll start searching for your device and go from there. Just make sure you have your Bluetooth turned on that device. Let's say you wanted to add a second or a third phone though. So you've already connected one, you're like, well, how do I add another one? Because it's not giving me that prompt anymore. Go to settings. From here, I wanna go to connections. And then I'm gonna go to Bluetooth because I wanna add something to that connection. Connect new device. You'd probably see you already have one listed there, and you can see I can list up to 6 on this vehicle. So that's how you do that. All right, so FM, pretty self-explanatory. The only thing I'll point out is you do have HD stations over here, so I can select it. And it just gives me a few more options as far as the things I can listen to. Outside of that, I don't think I need to do too much explaining. HD radio stations will light up, and then you can see under 93.3, I have 3 different options I can listen to. Now, moving over to Bluetooth audio, once I've connected up my phone, it would give me that option. So if I've never connected anything, it's gonna prompt me right there to start that connection. My settings, I'm gonna point out a few things here that I think are important that you might wanna know about. Connections you already saw on how to connect up a car, or excuse me, a phone to your car. Vehicle though, there's a couple cool things in here that you probably wanna know about. Door setup is the first one. So auto door locks, the way the car is set up right now, when you hit 10 miles an hour, it'll automatically lock your doors, and there's a couple things you can change that to. When you shift to park, or you can turn it off, depending on when you've got kiddos and how crazy they are, maybe you wanna adjust that accordingly. And then unlocking. So right now it's set up to where When I open my driver's side door, it'll then unlock the remaining doors of the car. So if I need to get the kiddos out, or if they can get out themselves. Now I can set that to when I shift to park or when the ignition turns off, or I can turn it completely off. And just remind yourself though, that if you have the child locks on, they're not gonna be able to get open the doors. You'll still have the controls over that regardless of that setting. So that's just a couple of the door lock settings right there. So I just always like to point those different things out to people. Now scrolling down from there, some lighting setup, some maintenance setup, driver assisted, keyless access setup. I really like this one because at the bottom down here, you see walkaway auto lock. What that is if I turn this on, which I'm gonna, just for the guys who work here, when I get out, if I get 10 feet from my car and I have the key in my pocket, it will automatically lock the doors for me. So if you're the person who gets halfway into the grocery store and wonders, did I lock it? Maybe this is for you. That's the button that I use. It's great for here at a dealership because that way we don't have to worry about cars getting accidentally left unlocked. Now, the question I get is, well, Justin, if I leave my keys in the car, is it gonna lock the doors? Am I gonna lock my keys in my car and then I'm not gonna be able to get it? No, if the key's in the car will not lock. So that's just something to be aware of. All right, so moving down, Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. To use those, you would plug your phone into the USB, which is right down here. These will light up, so you can see they're kind of grayed out right now, and then you'll be able to select it and move from there. It gives you access to music, messages, navigation, the ability to use Siri or OK Google, so a lot of cool things in here. You have access to Google Maps, Waze, Apple Maps, so take advantage. It's 100% free. The only thing you're using is your data. And there's a lot of different apps that translate with it. iHeart Media works with it, a lot of different things. So know that these are available to you. A lot of people like it because it eliminates having to download navigation. And then if I have navigation built into my car, I don't have to download updates and pay for updates and all that because Google Maps and Waze and all those are forever updating themselves. Trip computer, you saw the trip over there. I can just view that same information here. So I'm not gonna say too much about that. SMS text function, if you receive a text, it'll actually read it aloud to you. So pretty cool once you have your phone connected up. SiriusXM, car comes with it for 90 days. After that, it'd be up to you if you wanna continue it. I wanna say it's like 10 bucks a month, but you can haggle with those guys. So if you wanna get a deal, you absolutely can. And they'll hit you up before after you buy the car to kind of let you know. USB, I can plug into the USB and listen, whether it be a device or a thumb drive. So if you wanna store a bunch of music to a thumb drive, you could plug it in that USB, or you could plug it into the thumb drive down there, that USB. And down here, I'll point out that you do have an auxiliary input, so if you wanna use that 9mm jack, it's right there too. And you see that I have a power outlet in case I need to plug in a charge, and I have the USBs that I can plug in and charge to also. So that's what's going on there. Aux input, I just pointed out, you know how that works. Settings, we just went through a couple of the ones. There's other stuff you can play with, so I won't touch too much on that. AM, just like FM, system updates, there you go. This is kind of cool because you can store music to the vehicle. So you can plug in a USB and then be able to store some of the songs that you like to it. So it's just kind of a nice function to have advantage of. Clock, if I need to adjust it, I can do so. Or if I just want to pull the screen up and run with something nice and clean, I can press and hold. I want to see you just tap on it to jump over to the clock if I need to adjust it. So not hard. Oh, settings right there and then I can get to it. So I'll show you that later if you need to see it. It's pretty easy to adjust. Honda Link's actually pretty cool. I always recommend everybody go to HondaLink.com. Depending on what car you're thinking about buying or if you've already bought it, it'll tell you what options you have available to you. So things like being able to start the car from your phone, lock the doors and unlock the doors. There's a lot of different features depending on which level of a vehicle you buy. And it'll show all of them to you and give you what's available for that particular trim level of the car. So I always recommend checking that out. If nothing else, go to, just to know that if you set up an account and download Bluetooth, or actually, you don't even have to set up an account for this. If you just have Bluetooth connected to the car, it's set up to where if you get in an accident, the car will first call you to see if you're okay, if the airbags have deployed. If you don't answer, it can call 911 for you. 100% free. So a lot like an OnStar to protect you, except it doesn't cost anything. There's no subscription to that. So just take advantage of that. When you're connecting it up, it'll actually ask you about it when you connect up your phone for the first time. I suggest you enable it, but you know, to each their own. So that's the touchscreen. Moving down, my AC controls, I can control left, right, and back separate of each other. If I have them synced, they're all gonna adjust off the driver's side. If I unsync, you can see over here, I can adjust them. I can jump to the rear settings and I can mess with their temperatures. And then I can jump back off of those and then I can sync them and now they're all changing off mine again. So that's just kind of a quick down with AC. My fog controls are right there. Car does have heated seats. So three different settings on my driver and passenger side. You already saw power outlet, USB. Over here, I've got my shifter, pretty easy and standard. Lower, drive, neutral, reverse. Ooh, reverse, let's show you that. I do have a backup camera here. I've got three different views. I've got a, normal, wide angle, and one aimed straight down. Straight down is awesome. I'm backing up to another curb, a car, a garage, anything. Dotted line, is where my hatch is going to open to. Side of the line is 2.5 to 3 feet from my car. So if I am parking or parallel parking, I know how much space to leave myself. So you can see that on all three of these screens. So it's just kind of nice. These are adaptive. So when I cut the wheel, they cut with me to let me know which direction I'm headed to. So they're not stagnant lines. Down here in the bottom, really cool feature. There are sensors off the back corner of the car. So if I'm backing up and there's a car coming from my left or right, it'll give me an audible alert and an arrow on the screen to let me know what the vehicle direction is coming from. It's called cross traffic monitoring. Cool feature, take advantage of it. It's a great feature. So backup camera. If I need to shift over to snow, if I'm driving in snow, mud, sand, I've got some options here that I can show the traction control settings. You saw the storage that I have in here. You know, my seats, my armrests, normal new car stuff is what I call this stuff. Mirror to keep an eye on the kiddos in the back, you know, all your normal stuff. So that is a quick rundown of this vehicle. This is the EX. It's a 2020. If you have questions, feel free to reach out to me. Comment on the YouTube video. I'm more than happy. I usually check it almost every day, so I'm pretty good about getting back to everybody. If you need to email me, jf_1064@yahoo. Or you can call me 737-443-9555. Any of those will work. YouTube's usually easiest just because I'm on there pretty regularly. Let me know. Hope you enjoyed the video.